The Intervale is leading the charge toward the next industrial revolution, one in which it can be boldly said that ecological design can result in more jobs, more profit, and no pollution. Big promises? Already the Intervale is taking the organic waste from the city of Burlington and producing high-quality organic soil products. Their large-scale composting operations are enough to supply both the multiple farm operations and a booming retail business. And building on that success, these creative minds then asked, what other wastes can we turn into profitable resources?
We're located next to one of the largest wood-fueled electrical generating plants in the country called the McNeil Station. That steam actually has energy in it. We began to ask, can we capture that energy as an industrial ecology process and create a competitive advantage by cycling that energy into a food enterprise center?
Future plans include using the waste material from a local organic brewery. The spent barley and hops become a medium in which to grow a variety of gourmet and medicinal mushrooms. Their local farm system, which currently produces an impressive 5% of Burlington's food supply, will be expanding to include value-added products such as packaged foods.
I really felt what we needed is models that work close to home. And if the Intervale is a model, so are 50 other things happening in Vermont a model. Therefore, Vermont itself is a model.
I recognize the feelings, I recognize the words.
Ooh. NRG Systems in Hinesburg, Vermont has created a unique and inspirational industrial manufacturing facility. One of only four Leeds Gold manufacturing plants in the whole world, this building produces approximately 80% of its own power, saving the company money and guaranteeing them security in what some consider an insecure energy future.
Our finite fossil fuels that we're using are basically millions of years of solar energy stored, and we're going to be using those up in 200 years.
And I think we need to change our way of thinking about capital and operating budgets. And I think going forward in this finite resource world, it's absolutely worth it to put in. It only took us 8 to 10% more, somewhere in there, on a cost basis to build this building versus a conventional building.
Isn't it amazing how much attention and consideration is being given to employee comfort here? I mean, these windows behind me, for example, are specifically designed to allow in natural daylighting. As a matter of fact, all these south-facing windows, of which there are many to capture the heat, also allow the whole environment to be daylit, virtually requiring no extra lighting. We're walking down what's called their main street here. To the left of me, of course, is their community, open office spaces where everyone is in touch with everyone else. And I love the detail of all these plants along the way. Not merely an aesthetic feature, you see, again, there's a specific thinking. These filter and purify the air. The result of all this, productivity goes way up, absenteeism goes down. Watch this. All around the building, you have this, it worked again, I love it, this feature that the lights come on and go off automatically. And I'm a little resistant to bringing in this impersonal, intimate space, but come here, it's worth it. These floors, the tiles, are made with recycled car windshields. Kind of cool, huh? And one last little feature I think is worth mentioning. The toilets have the option of being either half flush or a full flush, so you can choose to use half the amount of water. And little features like that add up. This building saves over 100,000 gallons of water a year. Kind of neat, huh?
The efficiency design to this 46,000 square foot building results in an electrical consumption of just 1/4 that of a similar size conventional building, 75% savings, which is encouraging them to call on architect William McClay to design an additional building.
Our growth has averaged over 30% per year for the entire time we've been in business. This year we're at about a 42% growth rate. And so, yeah, these are the reasons why we're expanding. So we had a long conversation about what is our next facility going to look like.
The building has to function for a lot of the pieces of the business, which are, you know, the sales folks, the marketing folks, the admin, the engineers. Everyone's going to be living in this building besides just the manufacturing folks. And so we wanted to do a totally integrated building and look at it very holistically.
So here's a familiar Vermont site, a red silo. A little twist on the story, though. Inside of it are these wood pellets made from waste wood, actually. And
All this, about 30 tons, is all that's required to heat this building, the whole building, for a whole year, right here. So all along Main Street are these beautiful paintings depicting the history of the wind business. And this floor, believe it or not, is made of brushed cement. Who knew they could be this beautiful and have this many colors? But that's not all. You see, all this cement is actually a consciously designed radiant heat mass, because underneath them are 8 miles of tubing to capture the heat and then radiate that heat up through this beautiful atrium and circulate throughout the building. And at the same time, all this light is allowed to come in. It's gorgeous, isn't it?
Tall buildings shake, voices escape, singing sad, sad songs.
So we're in the middle of a manufacturing plant, and you'd never really know it, just judging by all the natural light coming in, the quality of the air. And as they say, every employee, and they mean it, has access to nature. You look out the windows, and there it is, including, I find it so impressive, these huge picture windows in the back. So we're up here on the roof. I want to show you a couple of things. First of all, the whole roof is covered with this white reflective material, which reflects away the hot summer sun, helps keep the building much, much cooler as a result. And I want you to see, if you're not used to these technologies, you might think that those things on the left are the solar panels. They're not. Those are solar hot water heaters. And to the right, very well camouflaged, are the actual solar panels, totally integrated into the standing seam metal roof.
You can rely on me, honey.
So as the last rays of sunshine bathe these young fruit trees, they're also falling on these big, beautiful solar panels. And these are providing 75% of the company's electricity needs. More importantly, they're helping to keep 110,000 pounds of CO2 out of the atmosphere every year. Now, isn't that a nice thought to end the day?
Tall buildings shake, voices escape, singing sad, sad songs.
Isn't it encouraging to realize that for every example of sustainability and regeneration in action we've shown you, there are dozens more on-the-ground models we can draw inspiration from? Indeed, the state of Vermont itself is in many ways a shining example of where we need to head, and we've been proud to show it to you. For Regeneration, I'm Claude William Genest. So long, everybody.